We all know that this world is not fair. Some are born with a silver spoon in their mouth, and others are forced to live in misery. But does misery justify crime? Is it okay for an individual to commit a series of heinous murders and blame it all on the society? Peter Kurten, the sadistic vampire of Düsseldorf, murdered several people and blamed it all on the faulty German penal system and his troubled childhood. Kurten was born in 1883 to an extremely poor family of 15 in Cologne, Germany. His father was an alcoholic man who repeatedly abused his wife and children, and the tense family environment affected Kurten in the worst way possible. Kurten attempted to drown one of his peers as a teenager, and he also befriended a local dog catcher who introduced him to bestiality. In 1899, 16-year-old Kurten stole all the money in his house and ran away. Throughout the years, Kurten committed several petty crimes such as burglary and arson, for which he had to spend several years in prison. According to him, severe forms of punishment in prison caused him to develop deranged sexual fantasies and a strong hatred for society. After being released from prison, Kurten immediately returned back to a life of crime. He once broke into a house in his neighborhood with the intention of committing burglary, but when he realized that the homeowner's 9-year-old daughter was in the house, he sexually assaulted the child and stabbed her to death. The sight of his violated victim gave Kurten extreme sexual pleasure, and he vowed to murder again. However, the First World War had already begun, and Kurten was drafted into military service. He attempted to escape the barracks, but was caught by authorities and sentenced to spend 8 years in prison. After his release in 1921, he moved to Düsseldorf, and there, he met and married a former prostitute who also had a criminal background. Kurten originally intended to leave his past behind after his marriage, but ironically, his criminal tendencies increased even more. For the next 8 years, Kurten murdered several women. He either stabbed his victims to death with a pair of sharp scissors, or strangled them to death after sexually abusing them. He even slit the throat of one of his victims and drank her blood, which earned him the nickname Vampire of Düsseldorf. When four of Kurten's victims managed to escape, he realized that he might be captured, so he decided to throw the police off the rail by switching the murder weapon and by stabbing random people in different costumes who would give contradicting accounts to the police. After 17 years of petty crimes and murder, Kurten was losing his touch. He also knew that the police promised to give a considerable reward to whomever could provide any information about the Vampire of Düsseldorf, so he decided to confess everything to his wife and asked her to turn him in to the police to ensure her financial security after his arrest. His wife reluctantly turned him in, and a trial was held. After hearing Kurten's confession, the police were horrified and asked 5 separate psychologists to perform an evaluation on Kurten to see if he's sane. All of them attested that despite his terrible sexual fantasies involving blood and mass murder, he was perfectly sane and fit to stand trial. Kurten justified his crimes, claiming that the hardships he had to endure in childhood and prison caused the sadistic tendencies to manifest in him. Nevertheless, the jury found him guilty and he was executed by guillotine in 1931. Allegedly, in his last moments, he only wished to hear the sound of his own blood gushing from the stump of his neck to give him the ultimate pleasure before his death. After death, his head was sent for forensic analysis to see what was wrong with his brain, but the doctors claimed that it was perfectly normal.